So I have a bit of a moral, ethical conundrum. If you watch my latest like race vlog, I talked about how my GoPro went missing at the race yesterday. There's a lot I want to say about that. So there's a good chance you could absolutely care less, but this is really causing me a lot of like stress. So I just wanted to get this stuff out. I hope you understand. Essentially, my GoPro, I left under the start-finish gate to get some sweet footage of the quads going under the start-finish gate, and I forgot about it. I forgot it was there. That was really a big mistake by me, and I didn't even think about it for like a half hour. The entire course was torn up and packed up before I even remembered it. It was gone. Like seven or eight guys helped me look for it for probably 15, 20 minutes, which was amazing, which is why I love this community, which is why now I feel like I'm in this like weird situation. We got a sitch here. So I kind of forgot about it. Wasn't a huge deal. I posted, you know, on the Facebooks that I would offer a $25 reward just in case someone accidentally grabbed it and they found it in their gear. Like, I want that GoPro back. It's a matter of principle and just hate losing things. On that post, Tristan had shared a screenshot from Josh's video. And in Josh's video, you can see my GoPro like totally sitting there in the last like race off race heat. It dawned on me that I could go back and I could look at all the footage I have and try to see if I can, you know, see someone actually picking it up or see if it's still there, or see if it got knocked over, or just what the sitch was. And so I went through my footage and I was able to determine that at 4:11 p.m. the GoPro was sitting on the cone that was upside down. I stood up after that race heat and I went out to where the pilots were picking up their quads and got just a B-roll clip of Tristan and Brian Morris chatting in the process, like literally like hitting record, bringing the camera up. I swept across where my GoPro had been, and lo and behold, the cone was flipped over upright and the GoPro was gone. The time between the end of that race and that moment was literally like 90 seconds. It was 4:11 p.m. and then 4:12 p.m. was the time difference, so I knew the 1 minute that the crime was committed in. So I kept going through the footage. I checked with Rigo because I knew he was running HD to see if he had gotten any footage, and so he sent me what he had. Rigo mentioned that he thought Tristan had a GoPro pointed at the start-finish gate the entire time. So I shot Tristan another message, hey, did you have a GoPro pointing at the start-finish gate? And he's like, sure, yeah, I did. Let me check it. And he was out flying, so I think he probably checked it on his phone, and he said he thinks he saw someone take the GoPro. Just from, you know, when you're looking at footage on your phone, sometimes you don't really know what you got. And he kind of told me a description and this and that. A few hours later, he actually sent me the clips of someone walking up literally at the exact spot my GoPro was in, bending over, picking up a GoPro, kind of turning around, like shuffling it between their hands, looking down at it, blowing it off, and going on about their business. And when they started walking back toward the pits, and then this is really what gets me, is when they started walking back toward the pits, they literally kicked over the cone. Like, they looked down, you could tell the dude was looking down, and he just tapped over the cone with his foot that the GoPro had been sitting on. So I sent the guy a message, and I was a little bit more direct. I did kind of accuse him, you know, I saw that you accidentally picked up my GoPro. He came back and said that he had had his own GoPro out there and he was filming the race and he picked up his own GoPro, which wasn't even a session 4, it was a session 5. I'm making it sound obnoxious. I'll tell you, when I was on the phone with the guy, I believed him. I absolutely believed him. I wanted to believe him. So I asked him, hey, you know, I want to believe you, man. I believe you. You sound like a good guy. You know, can you help me prove that you were picking up your session? Like, can you send me a video clip? He's like, oh, I'm not a computer guy, I can't really figure that out. And I said, okay, well, let me see what I can kind of figure out. And he even offered to send me his GoPro. So I said, you know, check it out, let me just kind of keep digging into this, and I'll keep you posted. So I came home, I went through more of the footage. I mean, I went through every piece of HD footage I could find of people flying the track to see if there were in fact two GoPros sitting there. And there were not. There was only one GoPro sitting in that grass. I mean, I went frame by frame. There was not a second GoPro there. Unfortunately, after going through all that, after watching the original video again, like, I gotta believe what I see with my two eyes. It's sad, it's frustrating, but I'm not mad at the guy. I kind of have a weird feeling about it. So I know there's a lot of comments, like, stuff like this can't be tolerated. We gotta figure out who it is so we could ban him from the races. I definitely get that response, but even me, and I think of myself as kind of a very very like straight, narrow guy. Like, I really like playing by the rules. I feel like I try to do the right thing. A month ago or so, we went down when I raced in Springfield, Missouri. We went down there as a family. We rented a hotel room for a few days and made kind of a little vacation out of it in our hotel room, which was awful, mind you. I had those freaking sleep number beds. It was broke. Like, the sleep number beds would not adjust and it was stuck on pallet of brick style. But anyway, that's beside the point. This awful hotel we were in, I found a set of Beats headphones, like their highest end set of headphones they sell. And like, I'm an audio guy, so the title Beats means nothing to me, but these were a decent set of headphones. I looked them up and like the retail for them was like $150. Like, these were legit headphones. They sounded really good, and I know that because I was really conflicted about whether or not I should turn them in. And I even used them and took them with me. When I went to the race on that Saturday, I took the Beats headphones with me and I jammed out to some metal music while I was flying. It was the first time I'd flown with music, and that was pretty amazeballs. But I was definitely, you know, checking out these headphones because I really wanted to keep them. I knew in that situation that if I turn them into the front desk, like, they're probably just gonna put them away. It's probably just belongs to some guy who was traveling for work and he doesn't even appreciate them, and like, he doesn't need these headphones. And if I turn them in, then they're just gonna sit in some bin for 6 months, and then the folks at housekeeping are gonna fight over who gets to keep them. So like, I should just keep these headphones. And I was really close to keeping those silly headphones. They were cool. I was pretty excited about them, but the day we checked out, like, I couldn't bring myself to keep them, and I turned them in at the front desk. And I tell you that not to be like, see, I did the right thing. That's not why I'm wanting to tell you that. I'm telling you that because I think I'm fairly moral, I'm fairly ethical. It was hard for me to do the right thing, and so I get it. You don't have any resistance. You know, you pick it up, you think, oh, how are we gonna figure out whose GoPro this is, you know? And you pick it up and you put it in your pocket. And I don't think I would do that. If there had been a race there, you know, Saturday, and today I went to the park and flew and I found a GoPro, I didn't know who it belonged to, you know, I'd probably be pretty conflicted on whether or not I shared that, you know, on the Facebook page. I might just want to keep myself a new GoPro. I found it, I earned it, right? I don't know. I know it seems silly, but I'm just really kind of tore up over the whole deal. The guy that I think stole it says he's gonna send me his Session 5 just so I can continue making cool videos with it, which I appreciate that. But I guess I also understand the impulse to wanna try to do the right thing, but also want to try to save face. Like, when I turned those headphones into the front desk, I wasn't like, by the way, I used these for the past 24 hours. They were amazing. I wanted to keep them really, really bad, and I almost did. If my kids weren't here, I might have. I didn't tell them the whole story. I'm just like, hey, by the way, I found these headphones, you know? I get the impulse to like want to save face and still try to eventually do the right thing. So I guess the deal is I don't want to like alienate some guy from this community of quad pilots. I want to make a big deal about it so in the future he'll, you know, be more motivated to do the right thing. Talking to him, I don't think he's inherently a bad person. I just think he made a really bad decision. So, and I hope that there's never an opportunity for someone to sit down and make a video about my really bad decisions. So, I'm not gonna share the video. Unfortunately, I'm not gonna tell you who it is. I know that's controversial too because everyone's curious. I just feel a little sick about it. So, I just wanted to get all that off my chest, guys. I'm sorry. There's been a lot going on. Here in our hometown, there was like literally a head-on collision with a bus, and a teacher died, and kids were like severely injured. The stuff in Las Vegas happened. Other devastating things have happened to people that I know, and like, it's just a freaking GoPro. I want to put people first. I hope that like everybody deserves a second chance. So I'm gonna send you out with some DVR footage, because this is an FPV channel after all. Ton of flying today, trying to work on flying fast, and then I also experimented with a new hand launching technique. So I'll show you that. I'm gonna make you a promise I really hope I can keep. My intention will be to never make a video that's this much of me talking again. But if you're into FPV stuff, my goal with this channel is to cover the racing scene here in the heart of America, in the Midwest, with live streaming races, covering the happenings of the race. If you're into drone racing, be sure and subscribe, hit that thumbs up. I don't know why you would hit that thumbs up on this video. Hit thumbs, I don't care, you don't need to hit thumbs up or thumbs, you just do whatever you feel like, okay? Anyway guys, thanks for checking this out. Enjoy some of this DVR footage and my crazy hand launch technique, and we'll catch you next time on Heart of America FPV.